The market vendors accused the leaders of siding with these traders to put their merchandise outside the market, leaving those operating from within to make losses. We pay license and taxes, but the customer cannot come here and buy because they find all they need outside. They don't help us. Traders outside bribe leaders. Our chairman asks for help, but nothing happens. We are going to put all our merchandise on the roadside. We have tried writing to our leaders, but nothing happens. In September this year, traders from the same market staged a demonstration, closing all the market gates to all the traders' buyers. The traders, especially those operating from within the market, were demonstrating against some of the traders in the same market for operating their businesses from the roadsides. It took the intervention of the police to come settle the matter. However, 3 months after roadside traders were removed and allocated stalls inside the market, they have since relocated back to the roadsides. The demonstration came after complaints came that traders outside were getting more customers, yet us who pay taxes inside the market are not getting customers. We ask the authorities to act and not simply pass out warnings. We ask that those who are selling from outside be brought inside because they already have stalls within the market. The vendors have decried the poor working conditions at the market. We also want to be inside the market, but there is not enough space. That's the reason we came back outside. The Fort Portal commercial officer, Karani Michael, says they have ordered vendors operating on the roadsides to return to the market. Those selling shoes should go back inside and occupy areas where fresh traders are working from. The market stalls meant to generate revenue for the council are empty, as most vendors have decided to sell their merchandise on the streets. Story by Jonan Tusingwe for the news.